All right, just into CNN here, we have some news on General Stanley McChrystal and that controversial Rolling Stone article that cost him his job. I want to bring in Barbara Starr live at the Pentagon. And Barbara, we all remember the story. I remember you and I talking about it last June. What's the news today from the Pentagon?
Well, you know, it's been just about a year, and finally, this might be the final chapter. The Inspector General of the Pentagon has issued a final report today saying that they could not substantiate, they could find insufficient evidence of wrongdoing on the part of General McChrystal and his top staff that were mentioned in that Rolling Stone article. Basically, Brooke, they said there was insufficient evidence to substantiate any allegations of violation of military rules, policies, behavior, any of it. And this all goes back to the Rolling Stone article, which had extensive quotes and references to both General McChrystal and his senior staff while he was commander of the war in Afghanistan, making disparaging remarks about the president, about the vice president, right, about various public officials. Insufficient evidence. Very important to note, neither General McChrystal or the Rolling Stone editors agreed to talk to the Inspector General for this report. Brooke?
Barbara, what does this do for General McChrystal? I mean, he lost his job, as you said, as the commander of the war in Afghanistan. I mean, essentially, does this just clear his name?
I don't know that it has much impact clearing his name one way or the other. General McChrystal has gone on to be a lecturer at Yale University. He is writing a book. He has a consultancy that he works on. Mm-hmm. Just a few days ago, we saw him back at the White House working on a program with the president and first lady to help troops and their families. Still very controversial figure. I think people will probably just come to their conclusions about him and stick to whatever their opinion is.